report, Coquitlam.
Thank you, Honourable Speaker. I know the Attorney General wants to take a nothing to see here approach in her answers. And given the government's record on so many other issues, please don't be surprised if we're skeptical on her answers to date. I'd like to draw the Attorney's attention to the quote of the Chief Justice, of Justice Hinkson, and what he said. He said, "When another party of the exchange went beyond the lawyer's role as legal advisor by purporting to influence the responsible adjudicator's decision-making or adjudicating role." That's completely different than the answer the Attorney General has given us. Honourable Speaker, Mr. Doroshenko alleges that the Ministry of the Attorney General released documents under FOI that prove, quote, "the government is committing an offence and breaking the law." We've had a statement from the Justice. We have the comments from the lawyer. So, Honourable Speaker, if the Attorney General is so confident that there is nothing to see here, will she release those documents and table them in the House today? What's she afraid of?
Madam Attorney.
Madam Speaker, as I have said a couple of times already, it is the job of legal services branch lawyers to assist with advice both to government ministries and indeed to government tribunals. And the immediate roadside prohibition program, the reviewers being part of that overall system of justice in the province of British Columbia. They provide that advice properly, they provide it fairly, and we are well served in British Columbia by the advice that they provide.
Report Coquitlam on a supplemental.
Thank you, Honourable Speaker. And it is the Attorney General's job to ensure that justice is delivered fairly in the province of British Columbia, Honourable Speaker. And it's the Attorney General's job to ensure that administrative tribunals are not interfered with, Honourable Speaker. Hearing are serious allegations and questions that is in fact is exactly what has been taking place, that these tribunals are being interfered with. So the Attorney General has one way today to resolve this issue, and that is to table those documents so that the public can judge for themselves that justice is being delivered fairly. Will she do that?
Madam Attorney.
Madam Speaker, the member opposite asks that justice be delivered fairly, and it is. Advice is given properly and fairly and with integrity, Madam Speaker, and the advice is given by legal services branch lawyers in this case, and the adjudicator makes their decisions. The adjudicator, it is their job to maintain their independence and make their decisions independently. But Madam Speaker, it is a bit rich coming from members opposite who like to advise political interference often. They want political interference in the health firings, they want political interference, and they want political interference in the issues around indemnity, they want political interference in the issues around judging on real estate transactions.
Members.
They love to have political interference, but Madam Speaker, I can assure you I do not. And nor do our lawyers. And our lawyers operate fairly and properly to ensure that justice is properly and fairly delivered in the province of British Columbia.